So, you want to get more views to your video so that you can grow your YouTube channel? Then stick around because we're going to talk about that right now. Welcome back to Money Making Ideas, the best place to learn how to grow your affiliate marketing business using the power of social media. And if you're new to the channel, then hey, my name is Stephen Horn, affiliate marketer and online entrepreneur. Today, we're going to talk about how you can get more views to each of your videos so that you can get more subscribers and grow your channel. Now, the first thing we want to talk about is promoting your videos. And people will say share it in Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter. And while I agree with that, and you can find that in my How to Get Your First 10 Subscriber video right here, there is actually two more places where you can share it and get views from. Now, the first place you can go to share your video is Quora. Quora is a platform where people go to ask questions and expect to get answers from experts in those fields. Now, I use Quora quite often. In fact, some of my most popular videos get views from Quora on an almost daily basis. Now, there is a right way and a wrong way of doing this. The wrong way is to just leave a comment that says, "This video will answer your question," and then put your video there. The right way is to write out an answer and make your video an important part of your answer. You then can either leave it there, or you can go ahead and add on even more in order to get people to get more curious about what's in that video. Just posting a video can get you similar results to just posting a link. You will get flagged and Quora will hide your answer. Even if you choose to fight the claim, Quora will most likely completely erase your answer from the question. So you want to give really good answers to increase the chances that you can overturn the claim or decrease the chance of someone actually flagging your answer in the first place. Another good place that you can use is a website called Pinterest. Now, if you don't know what Pinterest is, it's basically a website where bloggers go to share and get engagement on their blog posts. This can also work for not only just increasing the views on your video, but actually doing affiliate marketing. To share your videos on Pinterest, you first need an account in a specific board that you're going to pin your video to. You can then go to YouTube and hit that share button, then scroll over to Pinterest and click share. It should automatically bring up a pin that you can then create a title in a description before adding it to one of your boards. A little sneaky trick that you can use is actually taking your Quora answer with your YouTube video in it and creating a pin for it and adding it to one of your boards on Pinterest. That way, your video can get twice as much exposure because you're actually pinning it two times, one as a Quora answer and one on its own. Additionally, Pinterest have boards called collaboration boards. That's where two or more people contribute to one board. You can join this board and then post your video on it. These boards usually have really large amount of followers on it and is fairly easy to get into once you hit 200 followers. Now, the next thing you can do to get views to your videos is use keywords and tags. Now, before you run off, let me explain. I'm not talking about keywords and tags that you search up and use yourself. I'm actually talking about keywords and tags that are either from a previous video that is doing well or from someone else's video. Essentially, what I'm trying to do is to get these videos to suggest my video after their content is done. If you're using this method with your own videos, then you should only use 2 to 4 tags. And if you're using it with someone else, 2 to 3 tags. Now, you don't want to use this with just any tag. If you're using someone else's video, you want to make sure that they're ranking in those tags. And if you're using your own video, you want to make sure that you're doing above average views for your video. Now, if you're able to get one of the top videos to suggest your video and then get your own videos to suggest another one, it'll be much more powerful than just getting a top video to suggest your video. This is because you can then create a stream of your own videos that just follow up one after another to keep people engaged. And if you're able to keep people engaged on YouTube, YouTube will promote your videos more and more often. Now, the next thing you can do to increase the views on your videos actually falls under the suggested type of content, and that is to create a playlist. A playlist would allow you to use some extra keywords and have a higher chance of ranking your video. Not just that one video, but all the videos within that playlist. A good rule of thumb for your playlist is to keep it small. Anything between 5 to 10 videos. Anything more than that, then people might lose interest and go off and watch something else. Here's actually a fun part, because you can use that playlist in order to increase the chance of you getting a suggestion from someone else's video by including someone else's video inside of your own playlist. So what I mean by that is you can go your video, someone else's video, then someone else's. So quick bonus, if you have a channel with 35 to 20 videos, then your video count is going to be low. YouTube has not gotten enough data in order to categorize your videos. Therefore, it's not going to know exactly who to send your videos to. Next thing that you can do in order to get more views on your video is ask your subscribers to share, like, and comment. The thing is, the more engaged that you can keep your audience throughout your whole video and the more engagement that your videos get, the more YouTube will suggest it to more people. You can ask your audience to like and comment with the B-roll that I use all the time, or you can verbally ask them to do so. You can do this at the beginning of your video, in the middle of your video, or at the end, or any combination of the three. I suggest that you play around with it and see which one get more likes, shares, and comments to your video, and then capitalize on that. And if you're going to use it at the end of your video, you can say something like, if this video has given you any value at all, then please consider hitting that like button, subscribing to the channel, and turn on the bell notification so you don't miss the next time I drop another video.